Third Saturday in October, we're T-Town bound for the Vols to take on the Crimson Tide in Bryant-Denny Stadium, knocking another SEC stadium off the list today. We're going to bring y'all along for the ride. Hopefully, Tennessee will shock the world tonight, and we'll get that big-time win. Vols for life, 16 ain't holding his breath, but we got a 2.6% chance. That's better than nothing. So, go Big Orange, baby. Beat the Tide. Alabama on the 35-13 win over Tennessee in the third Saturday in October. Gonna have a lot to get to right here to end this video, but you know, congrats to Law Tide, all the fans on here. I'm sure y'all enjoyed it. You know, down a stretch late in the game, you made the plays you needed to win the game. I mean, capitalize off of Tennessee turnovers. That's all you can ask for, really. And y'all did what you needed to do to win the game. When you're playing a elite program, you can't make any mistakes. You have to capitalize off of turnovers to beat them, and Tennessee didn't do that. Just too many mistakes. So, y'all enjoy it. Tua's out for who knows how long. Mac Jones came in last night. Y'all's receivers, though, did nothing to help him. Elite receivers, supposedly, did nothing to help him. So, but onto this game, I don't know how else to say other than just the worst, some of the most egregious calls that I've seen in a long time. Just not once, but just multiple times throughout the night. Where can you start, honestly? We have we're running a wildcat down on the goal line, and Bama's not prepared for it. And what do? The refs blow the play dead. There's no flag. No timeout was called. Just blow the play dead. Discuss it, then come back and I don't know what the hell was going on. So then, you know, Bama's prepared now. We get a false start, shoot ourselves in the foot. That was all she wrote. The hit on Brian Maurer had knocked him out the game. Once again, bogus. It wasn't targeting, but that should have been called roughing the passer, if anything. And it should have been a 15-yard penalty, which it was not. And it was, any way you want to chalk it up, it was roughing the passer. holding call on Juwan Jennings late in the game when he's running a wildcat. He gets to the 1 yard line. Actually, I think it was a touchdown. I think I seen him hit the pylon. And there's a holding call on that. Shoot, another bogus. The most, what other ones am I thinking of? Probably the most egregious one was, of course, we have Bama stopped, another three and out, all the momentum in the world. We hit quarterback, and Daryl Taylor's getting up, and he just pushes just ever so slightly on the quarterback, and that right there, 15 yards, unsportsmanlike conduct, drive killer, because Bama got smart and they ran the ball and they just scored a touchdown. And that is bull crap call. You cannot call that. If that was a flip-flop, I'm telling y'all right now, wouldn't have been a flag on Alabama for doing that. Another instance, bull crap, was when Jennings caught the ball, had about a 7 yard gain. I think it would have been 3rd and 3. He fumbles the ball, but we recover it, and they go back and review it and say incomplete. And all of you Bama fans, you can go ahead and admit, you know deep down, if Bama would have recovered it, it wouldn't have even been reviewed. It would have been a catch, fumble, and Alabama football. I'm so sick of these refs. They're trash. All night long, any chance, any momentum Tennessee was getting was just snatched right away by the referees. And it's ridiculous. Bama's too good to be given multiple chances. And I guess I never knew. I didn't really think about it too much because most of the times we're getting blown out. But it's just like it's in a close game and you ain't beating the refs and Alabama. So that's just what that is. But then it comes down to it. That's not why we lost the game. We lost the game because we literally have the most garbage, worthless quarterback in the history of Tennessee football. Like, I'm sitting there all game and Brian Denny just thinking, I wanted him to succeed, y'all. I really did. I said, how many chances can you get to prove yourself? And then he's making plays, getting out the pocket. He won't throw the ball downfield. Just go getting out of bounds. 3rd and 10, just running out of bounds at the line of scrimmage. I wanted him to do good. And at the end of the day, I just kept saying, just put Stroud in. We have 0% chance to win with Brian Maurer. With Jarrett Garbage Tano as our quarterback. 0% chance. And the play of the night, we got a chance to make it a one-score game in the fourth quarter. Bama couldn't drive the ball. We were stopping them. And what does he do? 4th and goal from the 1, or the 2. I think it was from the 2. We call a run play, because we pull the lineman to block. Huge hole. Any one of y'all could have made it through that hole. And what happens? Garantano, he says, what play call does he run when he audibles? Set F Tennessee, set hike. Basically just throws it in the friggin' end zone, fumbles it out the end zone, picks it up, scoop and score for a 100-yard touchdown. Garantano should never suit up and take the field again for Tennessee, y'all. He's putting us farther and farther behind. It's just like, how many times are we going to have to deal with this crap? And I'm sick of it. Just play Stroud. Maurer ain't playing no more, y'all. He's done got 2 concussions in 2 weeks. I'm done with Jarrett Garbage Tano. He's the most worthless quarterback that I've ever seen in my life. I don't know how many more times y'all need to hear this. I don't know how many times the coaches need to hear it. And it's done. It's freaking done. Just get him in the transfer portal. Like when they get back to Knoxville, his stuff needs to be boxed up. Deny his access key code or his key card to get into the complex. And he's done, y'all. He is the most worthless quarterback I've ever seen in my life. That's all I got to say about that. He wanted to play hero ball instead of handing the ball off. And he cost us the game. I couldn't even enjoy the end of the game. Just a great atmosphere in Bryant Denny yesterday. Best away trip I've ever made, and I've been to a lot of them. And I couldn't even enjoy that. And I'm still so mad this morning. He's worthless, y'all. He wanted to take it upon himself to try to win the game, and it is what it is. This season was over a long time ago, but you know, you have a chance to knock off the number one team in the nation, and that didn't happen. So See you, Jarrett Garbage Tano. Thanks for continuing to screw us over week in and week out. And hope y'all enjoyed the video. Didn't get much as much footage as I wanted, but go Big Orange, and we'll take it to Carolina next week. Probably lose to Will Muschamp again because we can't beat him. But it is what it is. It's college football. Go Vols.